joy to be able to come to your home this morning by the ways of social media, just to encourage you, to let you know that God still sits high and he lives down low. We are grateful to the Lord for all that God has done, all that God is doing, and all that God will continue to do. My brothers and sisters out there in the social media world, I want you to know that we serve a God that cannot lie. We serve a God that will not lie. He promised never to leave us, neither forsake us. I'm grateful to the Lord for this glorious opportunity this morning, because when I look back through the wheel of life and seeing all that the Lord has done for me and what God has brought me from, I believe that there's a whole lot of witnesses out there who can identify that God has brought us from a mighty, mighty long way. So this morning, as we prepare ourselves to come to your home this morning, I want you to know that this word is to encourage those of you who are saved to stay saved, and to encourage those of you who are not saved to get saved. Because we live in a pandemic-style society, in a time where folks are on the edge of giving up. But I want you to know, hold on, just a little while longer. Trust me when I tell you this, my brothers and sisters, health is on the way. I'm grateful to the Lord today that I'm saved. I thank God for the gift of the Holy Ghost. I thank God I can still stand firm and say that the Apostle Paul said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because when I think about the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, I want you to know, my brothers and sisters, that my soul cries out, hallelujah, I thank God for saving me. Let us pray. Father God, it's again that we gather one more time to tell you thank you. God, I've come now before your throne, asking God to look upon those in the hospital, look upon those in the convalescent home. We ask God to look upon those that are locked up behind bars. Look upon that young boy, that young girl who don't even know you, the part of their sin. But oh God, we pause now to tell you thank you. Thank you, God, for allowing us to see a day that we've never seen before and will never see again. Somebody right now, God, who are listening and standing at the crossroad. But God, I pray that you speak a word in their hearts. Lift up the downtrodden, set the captive free. God, I just want to tell you thank you. God, there are those who are in bereavement, but help them to understand that earth has no sorrow, that heaven cannot heal. God, I want to thank you for how you dispatched your angel and watched over us as we slumbered and slept last night. Early this morning, you sent an angel down to touch us and allow us to see a day that we've never seen before and a day we'll never see again. We ask now, God, to look down, oh God, for men, women, boys, and girls all over this land. Oh God, help them to understand that you love them and you care for them. Let them know, God, that you're still in the soul-saving business. And Lord, we just want to tell you thank you. We pray now, God, that thou will bless leaderships all over this land, whoever they are, whatever capacity they be serving them. But help them to understand that you, God, and besides you, there is no other God. You told us your word, and if we lean on your God, you won't let us fall. You told us whenever we ask the Father in the name of Jesus, you will do it for us. Now, God, I ask you to open doors like you never opened before. Bless like you never blessed before. Now, I ask one more time, as the Spirit of the living God, fall fresh upon me. Now, Lord, I want to tell you, thank you for the word, God. Now, God, I ask you, God, to give me a vision, the knowledge, and give me the anointing to be able to preach under the unction of your Holy Spirit. Oh, God, I just want to tell you, thank you for all that you've done and all that you're doing. Lay your healing hands upon the sick. Lay your delivering hands upon the burden. And oh, God, set the captive free. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. As I said to you earlier, my brothers and sisters out there in social media, this is your social media pastor of the small, I want you to know that this message this morning is to encourage you. To hold on just a little while longer. It may be a lengthy text, but I want you to know that God has given this to me, and I'm going to share with you what God has given me. If you can agree with it, somewhere during the message this morning, get in the comment line and just project in the comment line, knowing that you there's a blessing. And our thought for this morning, I want you to look at me, if you will, out of the 37th Psalm. Psalm 37. Psalm 37, we're going to read verses 1 through 5. Psalm 37, verses 1 through 5. Look at me, if you will. Fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be thy envious against the work of iniquity. For they shall soon be cut down like grass and withered as green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good. So shalt thou dwell in the land, and verily shalt thou be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desire of thy heart. The fifth verse says, commit thy ways unto the Lord, trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. I just want you to look at me out of the fourth and the fifth verse. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desire of thy heart. Commit thy ways unto the Lord, trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. And just look for me, I want you to write down Romans the 8th chapter and the 31st verse says, what shall we say then to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? But out of the 37th Psalm, the 4th and the 5th verse, my text for this morning is the victory of having God on your side. The victory of having God on your side. Now, those of you who are listening this morning, if you can agree with that, why don't you comment in the comment line that knowing that there is victory in having God on your side. So as we begin to read and focus now in the 37th Psalm, we find that David was like a lot of us. David was now looking at the ungodly, looking at those folks who do wicked but seem like they were prospering. And sometimes we look at folks who seem like they are doing good, seem like they are prospering. But I want you to understand, just because you drive a fine car, because you live in a big house, because you wear name brand clothes, does not mean that you are prospering. The most greatest prosperity thing that I've known is anyone ever who met Jesus. Because Jesus makes a difference in an individual life. So here we find the psalmist, and I believe that every believer or sometime read in the book of Psalms. Even when you're at your lowest point in the book of Psalms, you'll find words of encouragement. When you feel as though you have reached your victory point, you will find words of encouragement. So I want you to know, as I were reading and praying myself, asking God to give the word this morning, and this is what the Lord shared me to let the social media know that on your side. Just because we go to church does not mean that we have God on our side. I'm not ashamed to let you know there were times in my life that I lived and not having God on my side. But let me give you the definition of victory, and you'll understand the act of defeating an enemy and an opponent in a battle in a game or other competition. In other words, when you know for sure that you have God on your side, you can rest assured, my brothers and sisters, that you have the victory. So we find here, as we continue dealing with the 37th Psalm, the psalmist understands that there are sometimes there are storms that come with life. Sometimes there are obstacles that come with life. I've never seen so many believers now have become so frustrated and so discouraged until they're almost ready to give up. But here we find the psalmist said in the 3rd verse, he said, trust in the Lord and do good. My brothers and sisters, as long as you got God on your side, I want to encourage you to continuously do good. I want you to know if God in you, it showed up will come out. When you know for sure that you're walking with the Lord and you're serving God to the fullness of your capacity. In other words, we find that Paul said to the church of Corinthians, be thankful, but thank be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. So I want you to know that it does give us the victory. And I believe there's somebody who will listen this morning need to be encouraged to hold on just a little while longer. Somebody need to be encouraged on, yes, there is victory in having God on your side. And I want to take my time this morning to find the Bible declared that there is victory in having God on your side. Well, let's move on. Just go to Deuteronomy 20:4. And God and the Lord, your God, that is good, and he's fight against your enemies. Then he will give you the strength to fight against your enemies. So when I began to think about all that the Lord had done, when I think about all that God is doing, and we find here in the 37th Psalm where it is done, we find David said in the 4th verse, delight thyself also, delight thyself in the Lord, and he shall give you desire of your heart. And I want you to know, my brothers and sisters, there's a promise from the Lord. And God promised us that he would never leave us, neither would he forsake us. And God promised us, as long as we keep our little hands in the Lord's hand, that God will fight our battle. And I thank God this morning because I know for sure, yeah, the victory is knowing that my enemy will never win the battles. The victory is knowing that my enemy is trying to camp against me. And they desire to eat up my flesh. But I know that the Lord will make them stumble and they will fall. We find here where the psalmist declared now in the 37th and 5. He's going to make our ways of the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. I want to know, sisters, when you commit your ways of the Lord. Many Christians are criticizing about who God is and what God can do. Many of us find ourselves mumbling, grumbling, and complaining. But I found out that if I mumble, grumble, and complain, I'm not sure that I have God on my side. Since I know that the Lord, he's on my side. I won't mumble, grumble, neither complain. But I declare that I will hold on, because deep down in my heart, I know that God will give me the victory. Now somebody tell you, if you know there's victory in heaven, God on your side, it does not mean you won't cry sometime. But what it does mean in the midst of my tears, the Lord, he wiped the tears from my eyes. I want you to know, serving God, you're going to run into many battles. You're going to run into the battle of being talked about. You're going to run into the battle of being lied on. You're going to run into the battle of being criticized. But you've got to know for sure that there is victory in having God on your side. I've never known God to lose any battle. I've never known God to lose any battle. So the psalmist said in the 37th psalm in the 5th verse, you got to know that God is still in the best of business. I want you to know, as long as you got the Lord on your side, you can walk through the valley and the shadow of death. You don't have to fear no evil. I wish I had somebody who understood what it means to have a victory. One thing I know for sure, the God who I serve, he promised me that he'd make a way out of nowhere. He promised me if I lean and depend on him, I can hear. Psalmist said now, he want to remind us, if you trust in the Lord, he'll bless your business. If you trust in the Lord, he'll bless your home. If you trust in the Lord, he'll bless your children. I want you to know, when the Lord woke you up this morning, that's a blessing from the Lord. I'm so glad this morning I got victory over my enemies, because the Lord, he's on my side. I wish I had somebody who know that there's a joy in knowing that God is on your side. I don't have to bother anybody this morning. I got some biblical characters that I can call on to give me the reassurance. Yes, there is victory in having God on your side. When you know that the Lord is on your side, it means that you might wake up late in the midnight hour and find your pillars are being wet with tears. But all you got to do is call on God, who is your doctor in the sick room. I stand by to tell you, if you have the Lord on your side, it doesn't matter what you're going through, but he will, I said he will carry you through. So in the 37th song, they begin to encourage us, delight yourself in the Lord. I stand by to tell you, the more frustrated it is to see the child of God mumble, grumble, and complain. They criticize and talk about where is God. But I want you to know God, he still sits high and he's still looking down low. But you gotta walk in authority. You gotta walk like you have victory. You gotta hold your head up like you have the victory. And since I know that, I know that there is victory in serving God. There is victory in having God on my side.
when my enemies start to shoot in their fiery darts, and they think I'm gonna fall, but they find out I'm still standing, because the Lord, He promised me that He'll fight my battle. I wish I had somebody who are going through something right now, and know that God, He's on your side. Talk to the baby just a little while later. I heard David said, I know that God, He's on my side, because my enemies have thought by now it'll eat up my flesh, but I want them to know I'm still holding on. Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, can you help me out this morning and tell somebody there's a victory, and know that God is on your side? He said, oh yeah, I don't mind taking this land. I don't mind standing up for the Lord. Oh King, He threw us in the fiery furnace. He thought the fire was going to burn us up. But because God is on our side, He took the heat out the fire. I stopped by the jail. When you got God on your side, there's no battles that you can't win. When you have God on your side, there's no hills that you can't climb. When you have God on your side, there's no valleys that you cannot go through. I wish I had just one more witness who can tell me, tell the world there's victory in having God on your side. The victory is knowing that God's going to bring you out. The victory is knowing that God won't leave you. The victory is knowing that God going to take care of us. So I just want to encourage somebody, as we journey through this COVID-19, as we journey through this coronavirus, don't you worry about that. Fret not yourself or evildoers. Don't you be envious of them. But one thing I want you to know, be very sure that you have God on your side. I declare He'll give you the victory. If you have God on your side, maybe your marriage is on the edge of being broken up, but be very sure, if God is on your side, He'll bring peace in the midst of confusion. I know the churches are dealing with some stuff, we're going through some stuff, but we got to know that we have God on our side, and since God is on our side, He promises us that He won't leave us. He promises us that He won't forsake us. And the psalmist said, trust in the Lord. In the book of Proverbs, he said, trust in the Lord in all our ways, acknowledge the Lord, and He shall direct your paths. I wish I had a few witnesses out there who know that there's victory in having God on your side. Somebody sitting on your road, somebody in your home, somebody in your circle had thought by now you would throw in the tower, but what they didn't understand is because you know deep down in your heart there's victory and having God on your side. Sometime you felt like throwing in the tower, but the Lord, He spoke to your heart. He told you, hold on just a little while longer. I want you to know, talk to me, John the Revelator. John said, I know for sure that there is victory and heaven gone on my side. John said, He cast me out on a lonely island to let me there to die. But God, He took care of me. They tried to burn me, but the Lord took care of them. If I had a few folks out there, tell somebody I've been sick, but the doctor walked away from my bedside. But the Lord, who is on my side, He become my specialist. And He's the only doctor that never lost a patient. Somebody said, I've been burning down, but since I got the Lord on my side, He lifted my heavy burdens. Since I have the Lord on my side, on my job, they've been downsizing, and somebody wanna know why did they call my name? But what they didn't know, I had the Lord on my side. I had some folks who smiled in my face and talked about behind my back, but they thought by now that I would have been upset with them. But they didn't understand. I learned how to trust in the Lord. I commit my life in the hands of the Lord. And since I'm walking by faith and not by sight, because I know that I know that I know that I know that I know I got the Lord on my side. And every now and then, the storm of life began to rage. And because God is on my side, He speaks to the storm and said, "Peace, be still. I want you to know, because you've been born again, it does not mean that you're not going to shed tears. But what it does mean, when I shed tears, the Lord will wipe the tears from my eyes. What it does mean, the Lord, He walks with me, He talks with me, He tells me that I am His own. And since I got God on my side, I'm going to have trials, I'm going to have tribulation. But one thing I know, that God, He's going to see me through, because that victory and having God on your side, I'm sick and tired. I'm sick and tired of all these church folks who's going in the tower. Talk about I might as well give up. They're not in church. But I want you to know I'd like to be in the building, but always in the presence of the Lord. Because deep down in my soul, there is victory in having God on my side. If I had somebody out there know, if the Lord had not been on my side, I don't give up. If the Lord had not been on my side, my enemies would eat up my flesh. If the Lord has not been on my side, I'll walk away from it all. If the Lord had not been on my side, if the Lord had not been on my side, I wouldn't be standing today. But because I know that I know He's on my side, I know that I know He's on my side. Sometime in the book of Revelation said, since the Lord is on my side, if I serve Him night and day, He promised me He will wipe the tears from my eyes. Somebody out there in social media world, you need to know that there's victory in having God on your side. Set not yourself of the evildoers. Don't let those folks who don't know God fool you and think that God doesn't love you. God cares for you. God loves you. And I want you to know, as long as He's on your side, that's why David said it boldly, "The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not walk. Therefore I walk through the valley in the shadow of death, but I will fear no evil, because the Lord is on my side." He didn't stop there in the 27th Psalm, because he knew that the Lord was on his side. He said, "My mother and my father may forsake me, but the Lord is on my side." Paul began to call the church of Corinth. He said, "God will give us the victory over fear. But you got to know for sure that you have God on your side." I stop by to tell you, my brothers and sisters, when you got God on your side, Deuteronomy 1:4 says, when thou goes out to battle against the enemies and sees the horse in the chariot, the people are more than thou. Be not afraid of them, for the Lord thy God, which will brought thee up out of the land of Egypt, the same God who woke you up this morning, He will fight your battle. The same God who proposed on your back, He will fight your battle. Let me get one more through. And Psalm 108:13 says, "Oh God shall be back, and for he that is shall swear thy enemies." I'm gonna think I know God will give you victory over here. Lastly, James, first chapter, verse 12. "Blessed is the man that endures temptation, for when he is tired, he shall receive a crown of life, that the Lord has spoken to them that love Him." When you've got God on your side, it doesn't matter what you've got. You can rest sure that God will take care of it. When you have God on your side, it doesn't matter how deep the valley may seem, God will give you the courage to go through the little valleys. When you have God on your side, it doesn't matter how high the mountain may seem, you can rest assured He'll give you the strength that you right now under the sound of my voice. You're going through some financial battles, but I want you to know God's on your side. Some of you right now are going through some lonely battles, but I want you to know God. If you put God on your side, I declare He's a God that cannot lie. He's a God that will not lie. He promised to feed you when you get hungry. He promised to take care of you. It doesn't matter how dark it may seem in your life, I want you to know that He is a light in the midst of the darkness. But you've got to know that you know that you know that you know you have God on your side. And I want you to know the victory of heaven. See, the victory is that I can serve God despite of what goes on. I can serve God despite of what they say about me. I can serve God despite of how they look at me. I can serve God despite of what they call me. Because I know that He's on my side. And since He's on my side, He's not making enemies become your footstool. You got to understand, my brothers and sisters, that we're dealing with this COVID-19. God wants somebody to stand up and let the world know we already have the victory. The victory had already been won. God who created this world, God who wrote this world, God who said to us in Isaiah 26, reminds us of a time in our life that we got to come out to ourselves and let God be God. Sometimes in our life we got to be still and let the Lord fight the battle. But while you're being still, you got to know for sure that you have God on your side. And if I have God on my side, ain't no weapon to form against me shall prosper. I don't worry about the evildoers. My eyes is on the prize. I'm looking to the hills from which cometh my help. All of my help coming from the Lord. The victory is in having God on your side. You want to know why I'm still standing? Because I have God on my side. You want to know when you thought I would be crying or smiling? It's because I had God on my side. I'm going to sit down. I'm going to close out. But I got to call one more witness. I promise you I'll leave you alone on social media. Ask old man Job if there's not victory in having God on your side. Job right came to him and said, Job, won't you curse your God and die? Job said, woman, you sound like a foolish. You don't sound like no wife of mine. The Lord give it, the Lord take it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And because Job knew that there was victory in having God on his side, God multiplied, Job doubled everything that he had. If I can get some witnesses out there who know that there's victory in having God on your side, it does not mean that you're not going to cry. It does not mean that you're not going to have dark days. It does not mean that you're not going to go through the battle. It does not mean that there'll be no high mountain. But what it does not mean you won't get sick. But what it does mean when you get sick, He'll be your doctor. When you get lonely, He'll be your company keeper. The victory of having God on your side. I'm working with a lady that I know for a short time that I have God on my side. When I look back over my own life and seeing all the doors that God had opened for me because He's on my side. He walks with me. He talks with me. He tells me that I am His own. And my conclusion this morning, Romans 8:31 said, what shall we say then to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? When God is on your side, He's a God that cannot lie. He's a God that will not lie. He promised to take care of you. He promised to hold you in the hollow of His arms. The victory and having God on your side. God bless you this morning, my brothers and sisters. My prayer is that this message has encouraged those of you who felt like giving up. This message has encouraged those of you who don't know Him to get to know Him. Because I know that the psalm says, fret not thyself the evildoers, not the envious them. But look at that fourth and fifth verse. That's the meat, that's the meat, that's the meat, that's the meat, that's the meat. You've got to commit yourself to the Lord. And when you commit yourself to the Lord, you take your eyes off of these materialistic things. See, let me tell you something. See, this is what John talked about in the 14th chapter. He said, let not your heart be troubled. If you believe in God, believe also in me. Because in my Father's house. See, when you know that God is on your side, when you got through labor down here, God has a mission for you. So you got to understand that He's on your side. And since He's on your side, when your enemy starts shooting fire and ox at you, they can't hit you. They may stun you, but they can't hurt you. Because God is like, greater is He that is in me than He that is in the world. The victory of having God on your side. God bless you, my brothers and sisters. I thank God for all of you. I want you to know this morning, we're getting ready to go in prayer. But if you can identify with this message this morning, and you can declare that there is victory and having God on your side, just go ahead and comment and let somebody else know that. I thank God and know that there's victory and having God on our side. If we as believers start living like there's victory and having God on our side, crime rate will come down. If we as believers start living like we know that there's victory in having God on our side, divorce rate will come down. If we as believers start witnessing like we know that there's victory in having God on your side, teenage pregnancy will come down. If we as believers start talking more about the victory of having God on our side, our family will be more unified. If we as believers start letting the world know that there's victory in having God on your side, He will give us the strength to fight the battle. He'll give us the courage to hold on. Because deep down in our sanctified soul, we've got to know that we know that we know we know there's victory in having God on your side. Let us pray. God, our Father, again, that we come before your throne one more time to tell you thank you. My prayer is, God, that somebody will cry out, I yield. I cannot hold out any longer. Somebody will discover the fact, yes, there is victory in having God on their side. Somebody will come to the realization and say, I'm tired of trying to fight these battles myself. I'm tired of trying to work out my own problem. I'm tired of trying to fix my own situation. I heard the preacher say that there's victory in having God on your side. Somebody will come to the realization, I'm going to ask God now to come into my life. Lord, lead me, guide me, and direct me. God, forgive me of all of my sins. I need you on my side. I need you to fight my battle. I need you to lay your healing hands upon me. I need you to lay your restoring power upon me. I need you to deliver me. I need you to heal me. I need you to set me free. God, that is for the joy of knowing that there's a victory in having God on my side. God, I want to tell you thank you for your word. Thank you, God, for every listener. Thank you, God, for all that you have done, all that you're doing. We ask now that these and minimal blessings be accepted in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now, I want you to know, my brothers and sisters, as we here at Bethel Eden Church, certainly want to say to our presiding elder and to the Charleston District, we thank God because of on Friday, we fed over 300 people, and God is good. And you turn right around on Sunday, on Saturday, through our food bank ministry, we fed another 300. God has been good to us. I thank God because we were even here at Bethel. The scripture says, a city that's up on a hill cannot be hidden. We want to be a village. We want to be a light in the community. And God is blessing us. And I thank God for all of you. And I just want to let you know that on August the 9th, we'll be celebrating 154 years right here at Bethel AME Church. And it's time for the church to start letting the world know that there's victory in having God on your side. It's been too long. We've been talking church and we've been living church. The time has come now. We've got to be the church. The church really within our hearts. And I thank God for all that He has done. I want to thank God. I want to pause here to say to every member of Bethel, African Methodist, Episcopal Church, downtown St. George, your pastor wants to say thank you for your support. Thank you. Starting this afternoon at 7 o'clock, we're going to have our class leader conference call. This whole week, I will be meeting every member through their classes and their members, because we have to keep in touch with our members. And we've been doing this since we've been out of the church, but we've always been in church. And God has really blessed us, and I thank God for it. I want you to know that on Tuesday night, you can get the number off the website.
off our Facebook page. We have Bible study every Tuesday night, and you can join me with us. But remember, my brothers and sisters, this is your social media pastor, John C. Small. So remember, there is a victory of having God on your side. Until next Sunday, you be blessed.